I get so frustrated when I get these DMs that my agent is telling me this, my agent is telling me that, and whatever the agent is telling them, that's a lie. So in this video, I want to make you aware about 6 lies that you are being currently told by your agent. This video is really important because one wrong advice can change the path of your life. If you're new to my channel, then I make content on studying and settling abroad, which will give you an edge. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button and hit it right now. So let's get started right away. Talking about the first hilarious lie that agents feed you, and it's unbelievable. I got a DM recently that an agent was saying this, that a college is better than a university because it will provide you more quality education, and second, you will get better jobs after graduating from a college. Are you shocked right now? Well, I was shocked back then when I read the message, and it's good that the person reached out to me and I could guide him. So that's why I keep telling you that your research matters a lot. Please don't blindly follow anyone, because there are a lot of agents who are just after your money and they want that commission from the colleges that they have the tie-ups with. So now let's bust this lie. My personal opinion is that if you are getting a university, if you have the budget to get into a university, if you have the grades to get into a university, by all means get into a university. But if you don't, then of course college is also a good option, but don't leave a university for college if you have all the means to do so. Also, if you want a genuine consultant who doesn't have any tie-ups, who has actually studied abroad and knows the system in and out, then look no further, because I have my own consulting firm, Collegiado, through which I help applicants with the end-to-end university or college application service. I'm so happy and grateful that I'm able to say this, that all my clients so far have landed at their dream universities. You can check out the website link in the description. Talking about the second lie that you're fed by these agents, and this breaks my heart, because this lie encourages people to stay in a field which they absolutely hate and strips them of hope that a career in an entirely different field is possible. And that lie is that you can't switch your field. I have told you this personal story of mine several times, but for those of you who are watching this video for the first time, I'm an engineering graduate, pursued my ECE from India, and then I wanted to pursue my MIM, which I did. But the agents back home were telling me that don't apply for this, your visa is going to get refused. But that's not the truth. I already graduated. I'm doing a job in my field. So if an agent is shattering your hope of pursuing your passion, please stop that conversation right away, because this is possible. And some people might say that I got the offer letter from Schulich, so that was prestigious, I didn't get any visa complications. But then let me tell you that I have a few friends who are pursuing even PG diplomas in a business field after engineering. So please don't lose hope, you still have the chance to change your field. All it takes is a good client information letter in which you can justify your higher education and the link between those two, or if they don't have any link, then the justification for that. Now talking about the third lie that is fed to you, and that is to push you towards courses or colleges that you don't want to go for. And this is also pretty common. I get a lot of DMs stating this problem, that the agent is telling me to pursue this particular course from this particular college and telling them that the course that they like, that does not have scope. And the courses that people have talked to me, they absolutely have scope. So this is another tactic for them to just get their commission. That's it. So please don't fall for that. Getting to the fourth lie now. A person reached out to me on Instagram and told me that his percentage is roughly 78 or 79%, and the university requirement, the minimum requirement, that is 75%. But here comes the agent with a lie. The agent said to the person that don't apply for this university because they say that 75% they would accept it, but they just accept people with 85%. That's not true at all. If the minimum requirement is 75%, there would be a few students who would have 75% or even maybe less than that. I'm not saying 65%, but maybe 73-72%. So that entirely depends on the competition that year, how high the cutoff would go. So please don't get discouraged and not apply to your dream university, because you do have a chance of getting in. Of course, it's good to have a backup option if you feel that's a dream university for you, but what if you apply and you get in? Coming to the fifth lie, agents telling potential students to just pay the college fees and they'll make sure that you don't attend any class and that you can work full time during your study permit. Now, I can't say that maybe this doesn't happen anywhere. I've heard a few colleges deal in this. They just take bribe and they pass the students and that's it. But please don't study from such institutions, because these are shady in the first place. I would encourage that you do your own research, go to recognized universities or colleges, and don't fall for these things that you can work full time, because that is not legally allowed. Now talking about the sixth and the last lie on my list, and that is the agents asking you to go for private shady colleges. Let me tell you first how they will try to lure you. Those colleges have almost minimal admission requirements. Even if you had a lot of repairs, your percentage is really low, still that college will accept you. But there are a lot of issues which people face going forward, and the most important and the dangerous one is that you might not even get your post-grad work permit after pursuing that course, because that college maybe wasn't ELA recognized, the course wasn't up to the requirements that you would have to fulfill if you have to get that PGWP. So the agents can tell you that it's sorted, but you don't know the intention of the person. If it's just for money, or do they genuinely know that it's sorted? So at the end of the day, it just boils down to your own research. Don't trust anyone blindly. Cross-verify your information that you receive from agents or maybe even friends, and then take an informed decision. That is the best way to go about it. Otherwise, you might fall into all kinds of traps, because people are here out for your money. And now you must be wondering this: the Indian agents are so kind because they help you with the entire application process free of cost. But you should be aware that you are not their customer. Their customers are actually the colleges that they have tie-ups with, and they get paid through that. They have a commission system set up. For example, your fees is $30,000. They'll get a cut out of that. And that's a lot more than what they could have gotten if they would have charged you instead for the application service. So that's the hidden agenda. Also, before we leave, I have this exciting news to share with you all. Now you can avail a one-on-one virtual video session with me. The bookings are open. You can find the link to book that in the description and also in the first comment. I hope that this video has made you more aware about what you should do, who you should believe, and that your research is really important. So if you like the video, make sure that you hit that like button, smash that subscribe button, and not to forget that bell icon as well. Until my next video, take care and stay happy. Bye.